Hello students, today we discuss the floral description of Delphinium, commonly known as larkspur, belong to the family Ranunculaceae. Now come to inflorescence. You can see here, inflorescence is simple and typical raceme. In typical raceme, you know that younger towards the top and older towards the base. Now come to flower. Flower is bracteate. You can see here at the base of pedicel, one bract is present. Bracteolate on the pedicel, you see here one, and at the lower side, you can see here another bracteole is present. So two bracteoles is present. Flower is pedicellate. Complete, all the four whorls are present. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Calyx is present, four sepals are present, flower is complete, perfect, bisexual, zygomorphic. You can see here, we can cut the flower only from one vertical plane into two equal halves. Hypogynous, all the parts arise from below the ovary, spirocyclic, in androecium and gynoecium world, and colored. You can see here the sepal is petaloid, purple in color. Now we remove one flower. Now come to calyx. Calyx is 5 in number. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Polysepalous, it means it free. You can see here 1, 2, all are free. We just remove this calyx, and you can see here the posterior sepal, it's forming a long spur. Aestivation is imbricate and inferior. We can now come to corolla. Corolla, you can see here 4 in number, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Two posterior lateral petal produce into be a spur. You can see here, and anterior petal is absent. You see here, it is a gamopetalous condition is there. Gamopetalous means it's fused. Four petals are fused together. Anterior sepals are absent. And stamen and carpel is covered by the anterior lateral petals. These are the anterior lateral petals. You know that anterior sides where which is facing out towards our side and posterior toward the mother axis. Just remove this petals so we can see the inner whorls. You can see here androecium, indefinite, polyandrous. It means it free. You can see here, it is free. Spirally arranged in a 5 groups of 3 stamen in each group. You can see here, 1. You can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then each is alternating with the petals. Filaments, you can see here is a filler. It's flattened. You see? Flattened. You can see the filament base. You can see this flattened filament. Anthers is basifix. You can see filament attached to the base of the anthers. Dehiscence is longitudinal, extrudes. It is towards the outer side. Now come to gynoecium. We just remove this androecium. You can see here. We remove all this part. Androecium is monocapillary. It means it is single carpel is present. superior, all the parts coming out below the ovary, uninuclear, single locule is present, marginal placentation with many ovules, stylus short, you can see stylus present from here to here, this much, short stylus is there, stigma is simple, capitate, hairy. We now cut the section of this ovary. Remove first style. Now cut this TSO. Now we come to summary. We can see here five sepal is present or sepal is petaloid, violet in color. Posterior sepal forms spur. Now come to petal or corolla. You can see here it is 4 in number and gamosaplet condition 1, 2, 3, 4. And posterior atrial, they are forms spur. Now come to androecium. Androecium are indefinite and each are arranged in 5 bundles and in each bundle there are 3 in number. Now gynoecium is monocapillary, short style is present, stigma is capitate. You can see unilocular ovary is present and 2 ovules are present and marginal placentation, ovules are attached to the margin. Thank you.